Subscribe to our channel, The Music Machine Gun, clicking on the red button and on the bell to activate all notifications so you don't miss any of our reclusive musical programs and investigations.
Join us on a daily journey through the excitement. An amazing history of the Rolling Stones, a musical journey that spans over 60 years and continues.
On August 29, 1989, the Rolling Stones released their 19th studio album in the United Kingdom and their 21st in the United States, titled Steel Wheels. This record was released after a rift between Mick Jagger and Keith Richards, who had attempted solo careers, which fell short of the success they achieved together in the Rolling Stones. For this album, the Jagger-Richards songwriting couple produced nearly 50 songs in a matter of weeks, and included the production of Chris Kimsey, who had also produced the Undercover album. The recording was made between the island of Montserrat and London, and an attempt was made to achieve the classic sound of the Rolling Stones again, and managed to overcome the differences between Mick Jagger and Keith Richards, who reconciled on the island of Barbados, achieving a relatively harmonious environment that allowed the creative development necessary to achieve an acceptable album. The album was the first digital recording by the Stones. All songs were written and composed by Jagger Richards, except Almost Hear You Sigh, co-written with drummer Steve Jordan, who unofficially replaced Charlie Watts as drummer after his death. The album begins with Sad, 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 and there is no doubt that this song captures the classic sound that the Rolling Stones consolidated in the 70s. The voice, the guitars, and even the metals have that unique sound that distinguishes to any other band. The second song from Side A is Mixed Emotions, released as the first single from the album. It climbed to the top 10 in the United States, peaking at number 5. It was also number 1 on the mainstream rock tracks chart for 5 weeks. This is significant, as it would be the Stones' last top 10 hit in this thus far, but they would go on to have more hits on the mainstream rock charts. The third is Side Track, It's Terrifying. The Watts Wyman engine room stoked up on funk fuel gave Mick Jagger an opportunity to drop his tendency to bark aggressively whenever a microphone was thrust under his nose. He did, and instead turned in one of those accentuated groove mumbling vocals which found favor in the mid-70s, on material like Fingerprint File and Hot Stuff. The fourth song on Side is Hold On To Your Hat, a really powerful song that reminds us a bit of Rip This Joint from Exile on Main Street. The bass was played by Ronnie Wood, and there is a duel of guitars between Keith Richards and Mick Jagger, which is boosted by an energized Charlie Watts, giving a punk rock edge to this excellent Rolling Stones song. The fourth song on Side is Hearts For Sale, an 80s song with a heavy touch, but the chorus loses a bit of strength and is very similar to Mick Jagger's songs for his solo albums that are not so relevant, like his songs for the Rolling Stones, except the harmonica at the end of the song that is remarkable. Side concludes with the ballad Blinded By Love, whose melody reminds us of Blue Turns To Gray, and which has a certain country touch. Mick Jagger invokes a selection of tragic lovers from history to warn about the dangers of passionate love, which can lead astray the men of their destiny and lead them to ruin. Hence Marco Antonio, ruined by his love for the Queen of the Nile, Samson, betrayed by Delilah, and the poor Prince of Wales, Edward, Duke of Windsor, forced to abdicate by the beautiful eyes of a second-hand American lady. The B-side of the album begins with Rock in a Hard Place, which is a perfect song for radio and which became the second promotional support song for the album, and of which Mick Jagger said, "This is one of those songs like Start Me Up, that from the moment you hear the first notes, your head is a dance floor. It's the 70s, in the best possible way." It continues with Can't Be Seen, sung by Keith Richards, a very good song. Energetic with a sensitive and romantic chorus, it could be said that it is the twin sister of I Wanna Hold You from the Undercover album, also sung by Keith Richards. The third song on Side B, Almost Hear You Sigh, taken from the recording sessions for Keith Richards' solo album Talk Is Cheap, written by drummer Steve Jordan, and lyrics arranged by Mick Jagger with the help of his brother Chris Jagger, and where Keith displayed rudiments of classical guitar. The fourth song on Side B is Continental Drift, which is really outstanding, with a touch of the mysterious Orient. and it seems that Mick Jagger and Keith Richards wanted to pay tribute to Brian Jones, as the recording featured the hypnotic sounds of master musician Zijuka, led by Bashir Atter from Morocco, who met Brian Jones in 1967, who was an icon among the locals. The penultimate song on the album is Break the Spell, a very particular blues that seems like an epic version of a Rolling Stones song from the mid-60s called Looking Tired. The album ends with Slipping Away, a typical ballad in the style of Keith Richards, who is the truly romantic of the Rolling Stones, and just as the ultimate concert closed the 60s with a bang. This song seems to suggest us in a tone more delicate the culmination of the 80s, and welcome the 90s.
We are waiting for you tomorrow on this same channel, in a new chapter of Traveling in Time, with the Rolling Stones. See you tomorrow.